for everybody's favorite guessing game, What's My Line? Brought to you by Remington Rand, makers of the world's number one electric shaver, the Remington. Now, let's all play What's My Line?
Now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the popular Broadway columnist, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
On my left, a gentleman that we think is not only funny and charming, but just great, Fred Allen.
Thank you, Dorothy. And on my left, ladies and gentlemen, the oldest living president of a Jessica Dragonette fan club, Miss Arlene Francis.
I guess I can be grateful you didn't say Theda Barra. And on my left, the distinguished publisher and columnist, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
And on my left, the positively only news analyst and panel moderator who was born in Johannesburg, South Africa. In fact, he's known as Johannes John Daly.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line. Tonight, we have got some tricks up our sleeves, which we trust will hit the panel right over the heads. We're going to have a famous challenger, too, a little later on, but I think we should get to some of our other tricks first, so it's time for the experts to meet our first challenger, whose line has to be spotted. Would you sign in, please, ma'am? Nicole Germain. Is that right? Very fine, firm hand.
Is my spelling good?
Spelling is excellent.
Fine.
Splendid. Is it Miss or Mrs.?
Mrs. Does it matter very much?
No, actually, this is more for the information of everybody around and about. Makes a lot of difference, you know, in some ways, but not particularly with reference to what we're going to do here.
Makes a lot of difference to my husband.
Yes, I'll bet. Is he very big? I'm 6'1 and weigh 100. What? Oh, yes. Well, let's get on. Actually, I'd like to chat with you all night here, but the panel's going to have to do all the work, so you go over and let them get a closer look at you, will you?
You didn't say where you're from, Mr. Nicole.
A secret.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Secret. Thank you very much.
How do you?
You have no...
All right, will you come over here now?
No other muff for the other hand. Isn't that a shame?
Mrs. Germain and sit here with me. Bennett made the point that we didn't find out where you're from, so would you announce that out loud?
Montreal, Canada.
Montreal, Canada. And we have some friends in the house, too, for you, from Montreal. Mm-hmm. And what we do at this point is let the panel have one free guess as to what your line may be. We'll begin the free guesses with Miss Kilgallen.
I think she's a diplomat.
A diplomat, Mr. Allen.
Oh, thank you, Miss Kilgallen.
I would say from Montreal, she's a lady hockey player.
A lady hockey player. Miss Francis.
Skiing instructress.
Mr. Cerf.
Oh, she's a bobsledder.
No, I'm afraid nobody has it. We'll let our viewers have a further look at Mrs. Nicole Germain, and at the same time, we will tell them what her line is. But the panel's going to have to dig. All right. Mrs. Germain, I don't know whether you see our program. Do you know how we score this?
Oh, yes.
You see the program up in Canada? Fine. Well, you know how we score it, so I won't go through that. Mm-hmm. I will just announce that Mrs. Germain is salaried, and let's begin the general questioning with Fred Allen.
Miss Germain, do you deal in services?
Yes.
Is there a product involved in what you do?
Is there what?
A product involved in these services?
No.
No, that's one down.
I was on about as long as the president of Costa Rica.
One down and nine to go, Miss Francis.
And more fun, too. Miss Germain, do people come to you for any service rather than you're going to them?
Well, yes.
In a way, they come to me, yes.
Do you touch them in any way?
No.
No, that's two down and eight to go, Mr. Sir.
Well, that's too bad for them.
Miss Germain, without meaning to get personal, I think that a person as beautiful as you are should have some part in the entertainment world. Do you?
Thank you, and it's yes.
It is yes?
Yes.
Do you do some kind of a performance that people watch in a theater or nightclub?
Just a moment, please.
Sorry, we have to have a concert.
Oh, I knew we were going to have a concert.
Oh, please.
She's saying, what are you doing on Thursday?
All right, do you want to do it or do you want me to do it?
Oh, I'll do it.
You
brave.
Do it. All right,
brave.
Go ahead.
No.
No. Read on, it's better to go.
That, no.
Miss Gilgallon.
But people are permitted to watch what you do.
Yes.
Do you move about?
No.
No.
You stand perfectly still.
Sorry.
No.
No moving about. Four down to six to go, Mr. Allen.
You don't do this in a theater?
Now, that what has been elicited is it is not done in a theater or nightclub, I believe.
Nightclub either. Is it entertaining what you do?
I hope so.
Well, is that the general agreement?
Yes, the general opinion, yes.
Does it involve your voice in any way?
It does.
I know it's not anything as simple as singing. You didn't come all the way from Montreal. A bird wouldn't come down this far to sing.
Not anything as simple as singing, Fred.
So well, is it done indoors? Is your voice used indoors?
Yes.
Is it done in any particular type of store or building?
Store or building?
A department store?
No.
No, and I think there, on the basis of the theme of the question, you'll understand the no later on, Fred. That's five down.
I'd like to know now if I could. I may be gone later on.
But since your voice is important, one takes it that if you do not sing for Fred Allen, you might talk for him. Do you do that?
I do.
Would you, you certainly would be charming at it. Do you sit at a panel ever?
Yes.
Would it be a panel on television?
Yes.
And I want to thank whoever from the audience.
More help from the audience, please.
Is this panel television show very successful in Montreal or in Canada?
Very successful. Even
is it
if
by
I say
any
so myself?
Chance the What's My Line show in Canada?
Yes,
that's
right. Yes.
Mr. You're Mind is probably the Fred Allen up there.
They're almost as good as you are. I must say these.
Which chair do you sit in, Mr. Mind? Which one of the four chairs do you sit in?
The second one.
Well, goodbye, everybody.
What do they call What's My Line up in Canada?
Chacun son métier.
To each his
trade.
Yes. That's right. Chacun son métier.
But don't they do it in the theater? Where do they do it? In the street or something?
A hall.
In a hall. Still
in a hall.
No, it's not a.
Well, I said indoors, and you said no.
No, but not in the apartment.
We said indoors.
Well, don't you have an audience that watches you?
Yes.
Wouldn't that be a theater?
Is that a theater?
Mm-mm, no,
it's not a theater.
It's a studio. It's a studio, television studio.
Well, this is a
sorry, kids. Actually,
Well, if you're going to be a
Well, Mr. Germain, you haven't met the other challengers tonight.
I asked
that you not be allowed to meet them because
they kept me locked.
They kept you upstairs.
In a cell.
Well, that's what I asked.
I was getting worried, you know.
I know she's going to replace me. I feel it.
No, we're not going to ask to replace you, but I was going to ask Mr. Germain, would you play one round with us just to see how you do
it? You said one.
Yes, not more than one, I promise.
Because I had a show last night, you know.
All right, just one round.
Once a week is enough.
Will you pull that chair over next to you?
I will.
And let Mrs. Germain sit next to you. That'll be fun. You go on over and join the panel then, and we'll see what we can do with another show.
To tell you the truth, we've got a secret. What's our lineup? It's black and white and fun all over again. Saturdays at 11, only on BUZZR.
Why'd you do a nutty thing like this?
Let's play.
All right, you all set, everybody? Mrs. Germain, you're all ready to go? We'll get the markers back again, and let's see what the panel, all five of you, can do with another challenger. Will you come in and sign in, please, ma'am? Alice Crisafulli, right? Mrs. Crisafulli, panel. Fine. And where are you from, ma'am?
Boyceville, New York.
Boyceville, New York. Yep. Where's that, up north part of the state?
Partway up.
Oh, up in that area. Well, that's fun. Big state, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Well, it's a big stage. Would you take a small hike over there so that all five panelists can get a look at you, please?
Sorry?
Mm-hmm. Hello, Mr. Sally.
It's too bad you didn't bring your chair. You could join us, too. Make a big economy-sized panel here.
And the panel gets one free guess now as to what your line may be. Would you come in a bit closer, please? And we begin the free guesses with Miss Kilgallen.
I think she's an instructor in athletics.
Instructor in athletics. Mr. Allen.
I think she's a chaperone at Girlsville, which is near Boyceville up there.
Miss Fred.
I think she's a mechanic, Miss Crispelli.
Mr. Zerf.
I think she wrote the town slogan, Boyceville will be Boyceville.
Well, we can get this program off the air faster than you can count. All right, Mrs. Germain.
I think she's a model for a toothpaste ad.
A model for a toothpaste ad?
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm afraid nobody's got it. We'll let our audience have a further look at Mrs. Alice Crisafulli. At the same time, we will tell them what her line is, but the panel's going to have to work. All right. Mrs. Crisafulli, you know how we score with these things here?
Yes.
Which time you give a no answer, flip. All set?
Yes, sir.
Mrs. Crisafulli is self-employed. Let's begin the general questioning with Bennett Cerf.
Well, Mrs. Crisafulli, I hope I'm safe in saying there are no television shows emanating from Boyceville. Is that correct?
Yes.
So you're not in the entertainment business. Is that correct?
Yes.
But you are self-employed.
Yes.
Is there a product involved with what you do?
Yes.
Do you make something?
No.
No.
No, not made. One down, nine to go. Mrs. Germain.
Do you repair something?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, does your work require any unusual strength or agility that is not associated with women entirely?
You mean some faculty of strong hands or of some particular physical feature that has to be developed beyond the norm for most...
I'm not going to cooperate with you, John. I'll get a no on my own.
You want it now or later?
I guess I'll get it now. I just mean... may I rephrase it?
Sure.
Do you use your hands or your body in your work as well as your mind?
Yes.
We all do. Now, do you mean beyond... Actually, I'm trying to be helpful, sir. You mean beyond the normal use, is that it?
Some well, I guess I really did,
yes, special application? Yeah, all right. That makes it three down and seven to go, Mr. Allen.
Well, is this product... the product is involved, isn't it?
Yeah.
Is it a product that is used or found in the house?
No.
No, it might be in the house, but it would not be kept
under strain,
there normally.
I mean, you would put it in the house on a bad day. Whatever it is, I mean...
Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
Is this product a product that could grow?
Yes.
Yeah, it grows.
Was it ever alive?
Yes.
Does it belong to the animal kingdom?
Yes.
Four-legged animal?
No.
No, not four legs. That's five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Crisafulli, is the animal still alive when you're fooling around with it?
Yes.
Is it a domesticated animal?
Hey, this is rough, isn't it?
Yeah.
To the degree that domesticated means that it has learned or has been trained or by its natural condition and state can get along in a normal society without doing damage, destroying property, etc., we'd say it was domesticated.
Oh, I see. I see. Mrs. Crisafulli, you said it was not a four-legged animal. Is it a two-legged animal?
No.
No, it's not two-legged.
It's a fish.
It could be a fish.
Six down and four to go, Mrs. Germain.
Does it have some kind of a voice or not?
A voice?
Yes.
You mean just a speaking?
It doesn't have a voice.
A speaking voice, a singing voice?
Well, speaking, no.
Just to make sound, any kind of a sound?
It doesn't make any sound.
No, it doesn't. That's right. That makes it seven down to three to go, Mr. Kilgallen.
Fish.
It's a fish.
is this product to be found in or near the water?
Sometimes.
Well, it's sometimes found out of water.
Yes.
Nothing like a fish out of water.
Then is it,
and voice,
is it, how you say in English, you know, the both kinds, like those planes?
Amphibious.
Amphibious.
Is it amphibious? In a manner of speaking.
Well, is it bigger than a goldfish?
Is it bigger than a goldfish? Hey, wait a minute.
There are some very small goldfish.
Well, since you say there are very tiny goldfish, we'll give you a yes on that, but I'm not absolutely sure.
Well, is it a fish?
Is it a fish?
No.
No. That's it. Two to go, Mr. Allen.
Is it, it's not a fish, and it's not two-legged, it's not four-legged. There's no breed that we don't know of living up in Boysville by any chance.
Oh, could we have a conference?
A conference.
10-15 seconds for a conference.
Maybe it has more than four.
Maybe it's a
Maybe
bug.
It's lots of legs.
Mm-hmm. It's like a centipede.
But don't go on this if you don't think so.
I don't think about anything. I'll go on it. Is this, is it anything to do with an insect?
No.
I'm down. One to go, Miss.
Get the bugs out of this question.
Now, I just want to be sure we've done away with several things. It's not a bird. It's not a fish. It's not an animal. It's not an insect. But it's alive. Right?
Substantially.
No. And it doesn't make any sound.
Doesn't speak. No.
Adam.
Judge Crater.
Hasn't got a voice.
Do you have anything to do with things that are chemical in any way, germs or bacteria? Or, John, I hate that expression on your face.
That's bacteria.
Experiment.
You mean non-filterable viruses?
I mean a molecule.
Molecule? No.
No.
No. You're not going to feel so bad when I tell you what it is that Mrs. Crisafoy does.
It's a baby.
She raises worms.
Oh.
She and Mr. Crisafoy raise worms, and up in the all winter long they raise worms, and then in the fishing season in the Catskills they sell them all around there to bait dealers and
Isn't
stuff
that
like
funny?
That.
That never occurred to us.
A worm raiser, yes.
Yeah, a worm raiser, that's right.
We don't.
Well, Mr. Crisafoy, you certainly gave the panel a rough time and us a very pleasant few minutes. Thanks for being our guest in What's My Life.
I'd like to know what category you think a worm is in, if it's not an insect or a bug.
What is it?
What is it?
Worm is it's actually.
Is it the snake world? That's animal.
It's not reptilian. I don't think.
Oh,
I don't know.
Him.
I'll have to look it up. But it's not a bug.
You don't know your worm.
Well.
Worm that turned.
I've had it. And in just a moment, we'll meet tonight's mystery guest. But I first of all want to say thank you very much to Mrs. Germain for being with us for that one round.
Pleasure, John.
It's lovely to have had you with us. First of all, the mystery guest in a moment, but first of all, here's Dick Stark.
Friends, let's settle this question about shaving, shall we? Now, the perfect way to shave is with the man-sized Remington electric shaver. Do you know why? Because only the man-sized Remington can give you a close shave, a comfortable shave, and a fast shave. Other shaving methods do offer you one or two advantages, but only the Remington gives you three shaves in one. The Remington will give you a close shave because it's powerful. So powerful it can shave the bristles off a brush, bristles tougher than the toughest beard. The Remington will give you a comfortable shave because it's gentle. So gentle it can shave the short, close fuzz off a peach without harming that tender skin. Incidentally, Panagra Airlines flew this peach up from Chile for us. Thank you, Panagra. So, close, comfortable, and the Remington will give you a fast shave. Just look how easily Jim Congdon is whisking off that full growth of beard. Now, that's because the man-sized Remington has three extra-long double shaving heads. More live shaving area means a better, faster shave. Small wonder, then, that throughout the world, more people buy Remington electric shavers than any other make. The Remington is the one shaver that gives you the three things you want: a close shave, a comfortable shave, and a fast shave. Why don't you see for yourself? I wish you'd stop in at your favorite store or Remington Rand Shaving Headquarters and ask for a Remington electric shaver on the 14-day free trial plan that's offered by most dealers. You'll be tickled pink with the only shaver that gives you three shaves in one. The man-size Remington electric shaver.
Take a look at this beautiful convertible. A brand new car!
Vintage Reelin' and Dealin' never goes out of style.
That's yours. That car. Yours.
Let's make a deal. Weeknights at 8 on BUZZR. Let's play.
And now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which my friends on the panel are blindfolded. Are those blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? As you know, in the case of our mystery challenger, we get right down to the general questioning, which we will begin with Miss Arlene Francis.
Are you a performer?
Jawohl.
German performer. Do you work in pictures?
A bissel.
A bissel is a sweeper.
So he's a sweeper in pictures.
Is that what you are primarily known for, your appearances in motion pictures?
Not exactly, no.
No, I would think not. One down and nine to go, Mr. Sir.
Have you ever appeared in television?
Jawohl.
Do you appear with any degree of regularity in television?
Well, I wouldn't say that now, exactly.
Oh, well. two down and eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Then may we accept it as fact that you do not have a program of your own?
And that's a fact, Ma.
Do you do something besides or in addition to acting?
Yes, I do.
Do you have any connection with music?
Oh, little.
Yes.
Are you a singer?
Yes, I am.
Are you a singer of popular songs more than operatic songs?
Well, I reckon I can do both if I'm called upon.
Are you a tenor?
A tenor, did you say? Yeah, some people might call me that.
Well, would somebody with a musical ear call you that?
I've heard a lot of descriptions of it, but I think they'd call me a tenor.
Do you also perform in what might be called a supper club act?
I beg your pardon?
Have you ever performed in nightclubs or supper clubs?
Yes, I have.
Are you a single?
No, I'm married.
I mean, when you're in a nightclub, are you a single?
Yes, I'm a single.
And panel, I want to put you on notice. We have only about 3.5 minutes to go to get this.
Have you ever appeared in radio?
Radio? What's that?
Well, it's a thing with knobs on the dial, and you get sound but no picture.
Yes, I've been on radio.
Have you been on radio with other people rather than as a single?
My shoes!
What?
What do my shoes mean?
Ma certamente, sì.
Oh.
You obviously are a very good mimic and dialectician. Have you used this in your work, too?
Oh, yes, I have used him very much.
You say that you're not a person with a television show of his own. Have you ever had a radio show of your own?
See?
But would you say you were primarily a singer?
See?
Well, I've got to take the plunge. Are you currently performing in a nightclub?
See?
Are you currently performing in a nightclub in New York?
See, see.
Are you performing under an assumed name?
That I am.
Is your real name McNulty?
Bah, that's the truth entirely there.
Faith, and are you Dennis Dame?
Ah, that's the Dennis truth.
Dame. Ah, yes.
That's going, Dorothy. I thought Bennett was going to nail Dennis Day tonight, but he got on the television.
I recognized four of the voices, and I had Dennis. I didn't have the
letter. Sounded like Alan's Alley to me.
Sounded like Alan's Alley, is right.
Well, you know, it's a tip-off, actually, Dennis, because there are only a few people in show business who are as good at doing that many voices as you are. And I can't think of the other one.
That for sure is true. And, Mr.
Dennis
McNulty?
Yes, Mr. Daly there.
I was going to try mine, but I don't think I will. There's an expert along here, Mr. McNulty. I don't think the Dailies can walk in the same league.
I think Dennis is very good at another thing, too. He made a living out of Jack Benny for a good many years.
How long were you, or have you been on the Jack Benny show? How many
years?
Well,
this is my 16th year.
Isn't that true, Jack?
1939.
That's wonderful.
Dennis, honestly, have you ever met a nicer fellow than Jack Benny?
No, actually, I never have, Bennett. That's true.
This seems to go for everybody. I had the pleasure of asking Jack to do me a favor a little while ago. I never saw a man work so hard to try to get something done for... really, he had no reason to help me out, but he did. And
Commercial for Benny, huh?
Yep.
I think we learned again tonight why you were on that for 16 years. We'll be on it for 16 more. Thanks very
much.
It's been very nice having you with us in Washington. One word to say about that. I hate to be left out on a limb with our worm friend. I don't think it's an insect. It's of the larva family, I believe. But I'll look it up and we'll see where we come
out. Back to me.
We'll be back in just a moment. But first, here's Dick Stark with a word from Remington Rand.
It's about the new Remington Rand printing calculator, the fully automatic calculator that prints, a machine that can prove mighty useful now that tax time is fast approaching for all of us. It multiplies, divides, adds, and subtracts, and there's printed proof that shows only essential figures. This multiplied by this equals this. Remington Rand Printing Calculator, a product of Remington Rand. Famous, too, for the Remington 60 Deluxe, the world's number one electric shaver.
Up next, keeping a secret is impossible with this panel. It's I've Got a Secret. Then people are actually rewarded for telling lies on To Tell the Truth. Stay tuned.
And now before our panel says goodnight, may I remind you to tune in again next Sunday at 10:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time when once again we invite you to play What's My Line. For other localities, check your local listings for the date and time of our weekly series.
This is the special value package of Stop-Et spray deodorant you'll find right now on drug and cosmetics counters everywhere. It means that when you buy a regular-sized bottle of Stop-Et at the regular price, you'll get this generous 47-day trial bottle with it, absolutely free. It's our way of making still more friends for Stop-Et, and it's a wonderful, wonderful bonus for regular users. Look for this special package that gives you the generous 47-day trial bottle free. But don't delay. This offer is really limited.
Well, till next week, this is John Daly saying good night, Miss Dorothy.
Good night, you man who doesn't know what a worm is. Good night,
Fred. Good night, Arlene.
Good night, Fred.
From the worm.
I don't think it'd be that way. Give my love to all my friends in Dayton, Bennett. Good trip.
Thank you, Arlene. Good night, lava boy.
And thanks again to Mrs. Germain for being our guest on the panel. And, well, good night, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for being with us in What's My Line.
This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. in association with the CBS Television Network.